it works magnets. That's the short version. The long version means steeling yourself for a light dose of physics. According to Lexus, its hoverboard relies on superconductors and magnets, which combine to repel the force of gravity and lift an object like, say, a fancy skateboard and its rider above the ground. That may sound familiar to anyone who recalls the Hendo hoverboard, which debuted as a Kickstarter last fall. You can read about the physics behind the Hendo in great depth here, but the key difference between it and the Lexus project is that Lexus opted for a superconductor which creates a different kind of magnetic field instead of a plain old conductor. With a superconductor you don't need to have an oscillating magnetic field, like Hendo's, explains Eric Palm, deputy laboratory director at FSU's National High Magnetic Field Laboratory. Instead you have something called the Meissner effect, which essentially says that when you take a magnetic field near the superconductor, it induces current in that superconductor and creates essentially an image magnetic field on the other side of the superconductor. You create current, but since it's a superconductor, the currents don't die away. So you don't need oscillating magnetic fields. You can have a magnet that levitates above a superconductor or vice versa, a superconductor that levitates above magnet. If that all sounds a little technical, try to picture a maglev train, which relies on similar principles to achieve speeds of, in the case of Shanghai's Transrapid, over 300 miles per hour. That's liquid nitrogen, cooling the superconductors below their transition temperature, the temp at which it becomes superconducting. Just how cold are we talking? Minus 321 degrees Fahrenheit, says Palm, who also cautions that it's not quite as extreme as it sounds. That sounds very cold, Palm explains, but liquid nitrogen is actually a byproduct of the steel industry, so it's pretty inexpensive. It's the same principle as the dry ice you played with in app chemistry, just around 3 times as cold. When the liquid nitrogen runs out, the superconductors warm up, and the hoverboard stops, well, hovering, until you top it off again. Here's one last bare bones, layman's definition that might help. Compliments of Norman. There's interaction between the superconductor and the magnet that repels the force of gravity and allows the thing to levitate, Norman says. That's why it can't be pure concrete in the video. There has to be something magnetic there as well. When you apply the same principles to a human bearing board, it really is like you're floating. He would know. While he hasn't ridden the Lexus hoverboard, he's spent time on a similar contraption in a lab. As it turns out, for all the anguish and anticipation around making hoverboards real, they have existed for some time. And they are not all that hard to make. And yet, a brief teaser of the Lexus version has racked up well over 3 million views in just 2 days, a response that surprised few more than Lexus itself.